Welcome to Out Past the Rings, number 166. Today we're talking about the Eyelet, the Howling in the Hall cassette that came out, I don't know, the cassette at least, came out on June 25th, 2019. But the digitals were actually released a bit before, and I will explain why. All right, so the story of Eyelet goes back to the fact that I reviewed their band a very long time ago. I think I reviewed like the demo or whenever they had like their old vocalists way, way back in the day. Because I was smitten. Actually, I believe I found out about Eyelet before. I found out about Eyelet's previous projects before I found out about Eyelet. So I'd already posted about them and then Eyelet as well. And then Eyelet came through in 2016. On a tour, and I was able to put them on a show in Hamilton with Fox Mulder, The World That Summer, and Wimp City. The show itself was really sick. Eyelet was incredible, and it was right around the time that Robbie had joined the band on drums. Now, you also had Tony in the band for this tour, and very important to note because this is the first recordings post Tony's death. So Tony died back in, I guess it would have been, I don't know if it was, I think it was early 2017, but don't quote me on that. Late 2016, early 2017. Obviously the band were in shock. Nothing happened pretty much during the 2018 year. Maybe that, I think the Jillian Carter Eyelet split had come out before. I think that was about to come out right when Tony died, because I believe we put it on the insert, like dedicated to Tony. Anyway, so this is the collection of songs that I guess were kind of being written around the time that he passed, or the first stuff that was written right afterwards, but they're an isolated section of four songs here, and honestly the four songs are some of their absolute best. Eyelet really did like a screamo thing, I think, for like a while, and then right here they started to get like a little bit more, like even more techie. And then this morphed very quickly into the more noise rock sludge, more like I guess sludge metal that we hear from the band nowadays. So these four songs are a little time capsule where I really feel like they were firing on all cylinders. And obviously there was a lot of emotional stuff pumped into this as well. You've got Weeds of Grief, Lower Than a Snake's Belly. I mean, like those two track titles right away, as well as the cover. I've never asked if it is in any way directed to the whole Tony situation, but it certainly could be, because I just think about his passing and it just makes me want to howl. The picture is, I feel like it's a very accurate description of the feelings that a lot of us had when we found out about it. So the band released this digitally. And they were like, these are the special set of songs. And I asked, hey, can we make some tapes for you? And they were like, can they be free? And I was like, no. And then I told Dave Cullen about the whole situation. And he was like, yeah, let's just do it for free then. And we'll, like, if you buy something from the store, then you will get one for free. We'll, like, lose out. Whatever, $5-6 or something like that, which really wasn't a big deal. So we just gave them away for free, and I'm actually in the end very happy that we did. I'm glad that Cullen was able to quickly talk me out of that. I love having these four songs in like the ZBR vault forever, and it's I should mention that the 50 tapes are all out. Like I said, it was if you bought something from the store. I think they lasted 3 or 4 days. And then they were all gone. Very simplistic stuff. You can tell that we even printed Dave printed the J cards himself. You will notice that the A side is Eyelet and the B side is not. Or C side. Or poorly done O. I'm not sure. That is Justin Orr from Crowning doing like a noise ambient side that he just didn't. They slapped it on the B side, and I think that's a really cool idea. So in case you were wondering what is on that B-side, that is Justin Orr from Crowning. He's the drummer. So, yeah, four songs are amazing. I think Lower Than a Snake's Belly might be my favorite, but, I mean, they're all amazing. And at ZBR Fest during the battle set, I believe they played Plateau, which, very happy about that. I think that's Cullen's favorite song. So these are gone. There was discussion that maybe we might be doing this on vinyl with Errors for that 10 inches Almost Gone. So we'll see what happens in the future. I would absolutely love to do that. I mean, if there's one thing that ZBR must be at least semi-known for now, is that we really love Eyelet. I've been reviewing them for a decade at this point, and Eyelet and Crowning are also like super tight. ZBR has also released pretty much everything. Well, we did the Jillian Carter Eyelet split, and then we never looked back. This has been Eyelet, Eyelet, Eyelet for everything that they have released since then. And I really feel like it's a good fit because we all just get along so well. I love those guys. They're so much fun. So, is there anything else to say? Oh, yeah, what's next? Oh, it's the Carrion Spring self-titled cassette. That is so much of a lead-up to that release. You have no idea. But we'll talk about that next time. And until next time, why don't we check out this little like clip show that I'm going to rummage through and grab all of the Tony answers from an interview that they did when they were here on, I guess it was right before this show that night, or that late afternoon. We did an interview on my porch. Do you want to introduce yourself to the camera?
I'm Tony.
Craig.
I'm Matt.
I'm Robbie.
Well, we've all known each other for long.
Like, over 10,
like, we all grew up together, in the same area, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That kind of made it easy. We all kind of knew what style and what kind of sound we were looking for.
Right, right. How are your voices doing so far?
Not too bad. The first few days, I was completely hoarse most of the time, other than.
But you got over it, that.
Yeah. Okay. So. Very clean city.
Wow, clean. Toronto.
Clean and
compared
sick.
To yes. us.
Compared to comparison.
We are from.
You are biased. Okay, so you recently had a new EP come out. What can you tell us about that, besides the fact that it's amazing?
Well, thank you. Other than that, yeah, they were all written with Robbie.
I'm a label. They've been, feel like this.
Yeah, they've been very good to us.
Yeah, very good.
That's
just
amazing.
Yeah, that's
otherwise it wouldn't have
been. So strange confidence.
Not cheap.
Yeah,
no, that's.
We're very grateful to them.
Yeah, they obviously love you guys.
It was a blast to get to go and
do a couple of short tours.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like Kilgore Trout.
The early stuff in particular.
Do we need to make that caveat?
Like, we need to go back to these guys.
Yeah,
we were all there.
A lot of milk banana or just like for me.
Milk banana.
Always like milk banana, but
pretty.
That one's just kind of about loss and then how your actions can sometimes cause permanent, irreversible. Issues down the road, I guess. So, kind of, in that general thing, it's a very short song. So
like, if someone else, like, let's say my friend loses someone, like, I could say something and it really messes them up more, kind of thing? Is that what you mean?
Not so much that, as it's kind of about, like, loss in general, and then also your interactions with some of those people that you have lost, before that.
Okay.
So.
Okay.